Hey guys, what's up? So a few months ago I got a comment from Manisha Mashalkar who wanted me to try to design an octagonal frisbee flicker. Well, it's not a flicker, but check this out. The octagonal frisbee from 4 sheets of paper, no cutting, no gluing, and this is how it flies. Yeah! Yeah! And check how cool the top of this is. It's a four-pointed star on a square on an octagon. Isn't that cool? Now, whenever I design a new model, I like to check the internet to see if anyone's designed it first. And I didn't see a frisbee like this, but I saw one of Tomoko Fuse's box lids, which looks almost identical on top. So she gets credit for prior independent discovery. The folding method that I used for this one is really different. And hers isn't a frisbee. I mean, it doesn't fly like this. Wanna learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here it goes. All right, so for this awesome looking and awesome flying frisbee, you need 4 squares of paper. For this one, I used 6-inch commie. You could use 10-inch commie for a larger frisbee or sheets of printer paper cut square, but it's nice to at least have 2 different colors. So for this one, I'm going to use 2 sheets of blue and just turn over the other sheets so that I have 2 sheets of white. And we need to make 4 identical modules, so I'm going to now show you how to do it. All right, so for the first module, since I want it blue, I'm gonna begin white side up. Fold diagonally in half. Try to make super exact folds and crease sharply. This model isn't so difficult, but the last step, the final collapse, is very difficult. So if you're new to folding, I don't know if I'd recommend this model, but if you're up for the challenge, then let's continue. Rotate and fold in half in this direction. And unfold, rotate, and now fold the front flap to this point. Exact. And unfold, rotate, and now fold this edge to the crease. And hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And unfold. And now fold this edge to the new crease. But don't fold it exactly to the crease. Leave about a half a millimeter. So it's like that. I don't know if you can see that there. And now fold this edge to this edge. And hold the layers down so that they don't slide. Okay, now unfold this flap and unfold this flap. So we're back to the square folded diagonally in half. Now rotate and fold this flap up. How far? Well, we want this point right here where the crease hits the edge to touch this intersection point. So it's like that. And when it touches, make the fold. And now rotate and do the same on this side. So fold it up like that. So that crease touches. And now rotate and fold this flap up so that this edge touches this edge. And hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And unfold and rotate. And now repeat on this side. Fold this edge to here. Hold the layers down. And unfold. And now fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. Like that. And repeat on this side. and unfold these two flaps and unfold these two flaps and rotate and fold in half. And lastly, fold this flap up so that the fold originates right at this crease right there, and fold it up so that this edge touches this point. Like that. And crease it sharply. And unfold, and the first module is complete. Now we just have to do that three more times, and I'm gonna fast forward this part. Okay, so the two blue ones are done, and now for the two white ones, begin colored side up and do the same thing. All right, so all four units are complete. Let's orient them so that they all face the same direction, and let's alternate them so we have white, blue, or whatever colors you're using. And now, take two and insert one inside the other, like this, and slide them. How far? Well, you want this crease and this crease to come together. So it's like this. And make sure that this edge touches this point. Like that. And once it all lines up, fold in half. You should be folding on existing creases. Okay, so it's like that. And now let's do the same thing with these two. So I'm putting the blue one inside the white one and sliding it to right there. And that lines up and that lines up. And this time let's fold it in half so that the blue one is on top. Okay, now we're going to slide these two pairs together. So let's start with the rear two flaps, and let's put the white one inside the blue one, the right one inside the left one, and just slide it in about that much. And now let's do the two front flaps. This time the left one goes inside the right one. Like that. And now slide them together. How far? Well, once again, you want these two creases to line up. So they perfectly align like that. And make sure that this edge right here is flush. So adjust everything so that they align perfectly. And now fold this flap up. We're folding up two units. So fold it up like this and try not to let the layers slide, but it's a lot of layers, so some slippage is probably gonna happen. Okay, so we've got it like that. And now fold this flap down so that this edge aligns with the bottom edge. Crease it sharply and do the same on this side. Okay, now take this top flap and we're going to stick it underneath this edge, just right into that pocket. So just kind of push it inside so it's like that on that side, and do the same on this side. So it's like that. And now unfold this flap, turn over, and fold this flap over this edge. And unfold it. and now stick it into this pocket. Like that. And like that. Okay, now hold this point and this point and separate them so that it flattens like this. And now move it so that it flattens like this. And move it again and again. Okay, so now on the bottom it should look like an octagon. And let's go ahead and take this whole rim and fold it inside. So just take it and fold it inside on the existing creases. And that'll just make it really stable. It's easiest if you keep it round like an octagon or a circle. Okay, and like this, it probably flies like that plane that I taught here. And crease it nice and sharply. And let's flatten it again like it was, like this, and then like this, and like this. Be careful not to tear the paper. And like this. Okay, so we have like an octagon right here, hopefully. And now we're going to do these little pleats here. So let's start right here. Make the pleat. Now the important thing is that you want all four layers to be together. One, two, three, four. Like that. And now fold it over so that this edge aligns with the crease. So it's like that. And let's do that on the other three such places. So here, pinch it, make sure that you have all four edges and fold it over. Two more. Here, all four layers. So like that, and one more. Okay, so we have it like that. Now notice that like this starts to open. You don't want that to open up. You want to keep that together. So now we're going to pinch the corners, the four corners. Oh, it's opening. That's not good. Hold it like that. Okay, so now you make those four pleats at the same time, and that's going to bring the four corners together so that they touch like that. That's what it looks like. And now what you want to do is take these two flaps and separate them, and these two flaps and separate them. So they interlock. Like that. Now, hopefully they just kind of interlock like that. If not, then you have to go back and make sure that the layers didn't separate. So that looks pretty good. And I'm gonna turn it over so you see what it looks like on this side. And you can just kind of push things together so that they line up. And now to make it stay, we're going to fold these four flaps behind these edges. So here's the first one. I'm gonna just kind of push it in place so that it's like that, and now fold it behind, like that, and wrap it tightly behind the edge. That's coming undone. I'm just gonna try to push it back into place. There, that's better. And wrap it over the edge. And crease it sharply. And two more. Okay, and the last one. Oops, it's gonna come undone a few times. That will happen. Okay. And so now we're done. But the thing is that since it's convex, when you throw it, it's probably going to tilt this way and not fly so well. So what I recommend doing is pushing in the center so that it's actually concave. So just push it down against the table and you can go around and just flatten this square region right here. So you see it goes in a little. And the more concave this is, the more that this goes down, the more when you fly it, it'll fly to the left. And so you just wanna kind of balance how concave it is so that you have just the perfect amount and it'll fly straight. And that takes experimentation. And one more thing, if these flaps tend to come undone, well, what you can do, I'm not gonna do it on this one, but I did it on the 10-inch one, because that's even more likely that the flaps come undone. What you can do is take this edge and fold it inside. So we're folding from here to here, just tucking it inside. It's kind of curved. And that'll just really lock the flap in place. And it'll make the edge go perfectly to the point, hopefully. And make sure that you get the flap in that fold. Like that. Okay, let's see how it flies. Here goes. Oh yeah! All right, so there you have it. So I hope you guys enjoyed folding this, and I wanna let you know that I just a few moments ago designed the Octagonal Frisbee Flicker, and this is how it flies. Ooh yeah! Whoa. And I'll hopefully have a tutorial out soon. See you guys later! Bye bye!